I would have loved to grow up in a world where that so gay wasn't a thing.
There's a long list of things that you should never call so gay. Someone's car is not so gay. A test that you bombed is not so gay.
Whenever it would happen, I would just get really quiet and just laugh a bit and be like, ha ha ha, yeah, it's so gay. It really is hard when you go out every day and you're attacked for who you are.
I know the argument is, well, I don't mean it that way. Like, I just mean that it's stupid. Find a different way of saying that, because gay's taken and it doesn't mean anything negative.
This is just such an extreme manifestation of the word that I think people will be forced to realize how silly they sound when they say it.
If ever there's an appropriate sweater to call gay, that is the sweater.
I love it. It's totally bizarre and I love it.
If you have an object that's produced biologically from people, could you call it gay? Well, if we imagine that the gay people have an identity that is rooted in their biology, then a sample of their biology can be said to have a gay identity. If you get hair samples from people who are gay, it's a gay thing.
In the crafting community, this is something that's very unusual. Yesterday, I went to the hair salon and bewildered the stylist by saying that I was making a gay hair sweater and that I wanted to add mine to it. It has been off of my head for less than 24 hours.
This is our first completed ball of 100% homosexual hair. So we'll use large needles and the sweater will grow top down. The human hair behaves differently on the wheel than anything I've ever spun with. And the first time I started working with it, I got so excited.
But it's actually awful to knit with. It's all over our laps. It's all over the floor.
So the longer the better, the coarser the better. Although we would love to get some more ginger hair.
Perfect, a little ginger in there. Well, it's not natural.
I feel very proud, actually. And voila.
To create something that is actually tangibly gay, made of gay hair. People are just full of questions.
Because you can touch it. You can touch the gayness.
Honestly, the revulsion is overpowered by people's curiosity.
Have you ever heard or yourself ever said about an object, that's so gay?
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, we'd be lying if we if we told you that we've never said it before.
But I think it's just a term we're used to.
Yeah, I'm just getting some opinions on the sweater. What do you think?
They might be grossed out, they might take a step back, but they don't leave.
It almost looks human.
It is. It is. Human. Does that terrify you?
A little bit.
It's definitely all head hair.
Okay.
You can tell by the consistency. No curls.
I love it.
Do you? Will you try it on?
It is very uncomfortable against the skin.
Wow, that's pretty heavy.
Gay as in happy or gay as in like...
Gay as in gay. The hair of over 100 homosexual people went into creating this 100% gay sweater.
Oh, whoa, that's cool.
This is one person in here. This is one person here.
I feel even more gay than I did before, just a moment ago.
Beyond looking fabulous, it will be educating people.
In literalizing a gay sweater, I'm hoping that people will reflect on what they say and how they treat people.
This is possibly the gayest sweater there ever could be, right? Anything else just pales in comparison.